I draw things out. I have to write things over and over again to memorize them. I have to read a lot slower. It just takes me longer to process. And for the longest time, I blame myself because it really made me feel like I just wasn't normal. And I went and found treatment. I went to see what was going on, and they ended up diagnosing me with ADHD. It took a long time for me to accept that I have ADHD, but I see it as something that, even though it makes the journey a lot harder than anybody could ever imagine, I'm here because I had to work so hard. I jumped into this huge research project my freshman year and just studied all ADHD and what is different about my brain. Because I always wonder, why am I different from other people? Reading comprehension has always been difficult for me. I was led to think, well, maybe if my attention was improved, then I could have better reading comprehension. And from that, I went to the literature and saw ways that they have improved attention in ADHD individuals without medication, and that was with neurofeedback training. We use an EEG cap, which measures the electrical output from your brain, and they're getting real-time audio and visual feedback in the form of a game and in the form of a sound, of a ding, indicating that they've earned points. And when they modulate or they control that brainwave in the way that I want them to, they're gonna succeed at the game. So I'm aiming to train two specific frequencies in the brain in a specific direction in order to improve attention and healthy individuals, in hopes when I improve their attention that their reading and comprehension also improves. I would love to keep doing this for the rest of my life and keep learning new things about the brain and eventually uncover things that we never imagined we would find about ADHD.